The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California.
Big time. And you are looking at one of the most unshakable superstars on the roster.
Absolutely a picture of resilience. He's been through ups and downs, but has never given up the fight.
Bitter perseverance is what will make him such a threat in this matchup.
We got Canada's favorite son on the other side.
There's no question Hart's an elite strategist, but will the Hitman be able to carry out his plan as he devised it? Or is he going to have to make adjustments during the course of the match?
I seriously doubt Brett is having any feelings of distress, Corey. Hart is so versatile that calling an audible is second nature to him.
Big two. Quick reaction to Hart there.
Hart gets out of there.
A big punch.
Ouch.
This could be big. Going up high.
Punched up top.
Almost lost their balance, but regained it.
No, the elbow drop. Hart is being stifled in this one.
Rare to see the Hitman baffled like this.
Desperate attempt here to get back on his feet.
Firm control. Hart takes a blow, and he had to know this thing could turn into a shootout.
He knew that was coming.
Boom, DDT. With the reversal. And he sends him into the corner.
One, two.
Series of kicks in the corner.
He's positioning himself, closing in.
Taken down. What is this superstar looking for?
Legs are great, but now the arms are trapped. This won't end well.
Oh, big stop.
I think the writing's on the wall, and it is not good for the Hitman.
Could this be it?
Good time to capitalize on Brett.
Perhaps the perfect match. Never any doubt in this win.
An absolute statement by the victor here tonight. What a steamrolling.
The following contest is a handicap match. Making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 274 pounds.
comes the tip. The odds are not in someone's favor tonight during this handicap match.
Not only are they taking on two competitors, the other side to tag out whatever they want. Tough odds to overcome, Michael.
Up the turnbuckles.
What's he gonna do?
From the top. Oh, and he doesn't connect. Face first with a waistlock takedown.
Setting up.
Nice suplex. Vertical suplex. Oh, clothesline. Clothesline.
Forcefully delivered.
Nasty right hand. Answers with an enziguri. Crashing to the floor. Stone Cold too slow there. And sent right into the corner. Oh, look at the kick right to the midsection.
Oh. Boom. Three.
Meet face. Looking for a high risk, high rewards. It punched up top. Almost lost their balance, but regained it. And nobody's there.
Austin dodges that one.
Oh, a rear super kick.
From behind, nasty.
Austin in a state of distress now.
Tough spot, even for the Rattlesnake.
Nasty right hand. It's a guy to the floor. Knew what was coming there.
Maybe he's found a new source of aggression to battle back with.
And he's taking on a persistent assault.
Yeah, the defects in his game are leaving him vulnerable.
And he said, you're not getting me with that this time.
Oh, foot just stomping down. He's getting a little battered now.
Kick. Oh!
He has him right where he wants him.
Takedown, step through, looking for a submission here. Legs are locked up. Uh-oh.
Oh, big stop.
Heading up, he's thinking big.
Nasty right hand.
Vicious enziguri.
Discouraging situation for People's Champion.
The Rock is not looking good here.
Yourself.
This is what it's all about. All the hard work, all the training, it's all for achieving big victories like this one.
been hearing good stuff about you. Even Todd in security is talking up your training matches. Speaking of Todd, Paragon J. Pierce keeps asking Todd to park his car like he's a valet. I need someone to put Paragon in his place. I'll even...
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 274 pounds, the American Dream.
One, two, three. Hey, glad you made it. I'm Baron Blade. Whatever you've heard about me, don't believe it. Unless it was good, then it's totally legit. So you two ready for the big show tonight?
Yeah, can't wait to check out all the matches.
I'm sure you'll be able to watch from the back a bit, but I don't allow wrestlers in the audience. Unless it's a lighthouse and we need to beef up the head count, but that's not the case for tonight. Especially after we blew up on social media, saying two future WWE superstars were competing.
Wait, are you saying we're in a match?
Yeah, I sent Chase a message about it. It said, bring a friend to the show, need more matches.
Chase, what the heck, man?
To be fair, the one other time we met, you talked nonstop about how much you loved collecting matches from restaurants you ate at. So I guess me bringing some from several different local establishments was a complete waste of time.
Oh, no, I'll still take those. Thanks.
This is exactly what I was afraid of. I didn't want anyone to know we were here, and now we're going to wrestle?
Not my problem. And like I said, it's already out there on social media, so you might as well go through with it anyway. You should probably go get changed into your gear, though.
I don't have any gear. I thought we were just here to watch the show, remember?
Oh, come on, man. You always bring your gear. Rookie mistake. Just wrestle in your clothes, I guess.
Remind me to never listen to you again.
How would I be able to remind you if you're not gonna listen to me again?
You're the worst.
Well, look who it is, the two hottest stars on the indies.
I guess you saw what happened.
I'm certainly not an expert on the old internets, but it's kind of hard not to see it. Footage was plastered all over social media.
What'd you think of the match? 4 stars? 5, maybe?
That's not really important right now. What matters is I wasn't the only one who got wind of your little guest appearance. You know, they do have internet up in Connecticut, right? So here's what I'm thinking. First time offense, your sentence is a crap ton of cardio, and then a match against the Viking Raiders. Sound fair?
Yes, that's more than fair. And I promise it won't happen again.
It better not, or you two will permanently be on the indies. Now go do laps around the building until the Viking Raiders get here.
When might that be?
Oh, about 3 hours from now. Go.
Hey, big news. We got another member of DX coming to help out for a bit at the PC.
Hornswoggle?
No. One of the members of the best version of DX, X-Pac.
No offense, but I actually think the original version of DX was the best.
Wow. Offense taken. It's funny. Sean almost tells me the same thing.
You guys were cool, but Sean and Hunter were the OGs.
Okay. What if when X-Pac is here, we had a match to settle this debate? You and your OG hero, Shawn Michaels, versus me and X-Pac.
I've got two words for you. I'm in.
Leave that to the pros.